this question was asked in year 2004. And in this question, they are taking four variables. The variables are X, Y, M, and N. So let us suppose this is the variable X, this is the variable Y, this is the variable M, and this is the variable N. Now, they are taking the values of X and Y from the user. Okay? And they are saying that, assume that value of X is greater than 0 and the value of Y is greater than 0. Okay? So let us take some values of X and Y. So let us assume that value of X is 40 and the value of Y is 32. Okay? Now they are copying the value of X to M and the value of Y to N. Okay? So what is the value of X? The value of X is 40. Therefore, M is now going to store 40. And the value of Y is 32. Therefore, N is now going to store 32. Okay? Now, they are saying in the while loop, so while M is not equal to N, this while loop will run till the time the value of M is not equal to N. As soon as the value of M and N are equal, this while loop will terminate and the control will pass to the next statement, right? So here the value of M is 40 and the value of N is 32, and 40 is not equal to 32, therefore this condition passes. So we are going to come inside this while loop. Now in this while loop, we are having a if-else statement. So if statement is if M is greater than N, right? So the value of M is 40 and the value of N is 32. Obviously 40 is greater than 32. So we are going to do M is equal to M minus N, right? So the value in, which is now stored in M is 40 minus 32 is 8. Okay? Now again we are going to check this while loop. The value of M is not equal to N because 8 is not equal to 32. Therefore we will come inside. So here if M is greater than N, but the value of M is 8 and the value of N is 32, therefore 8 is not greater than 32, therefore this statement will not be executed, right? So it will execute the else statement, and the else statement saying N is equal to N minus M, right? Therefore the value of N is 32, so 32 minus 8 is 24, therefore the value which is now stored in N is 24. Okay, now again we'll come to this while loop. Now the value of M is 8 and the value of N is 32, and M is not equal to N, therefore this condition passes. So we'll come to inside this while loop. The first condition is if M is greater than N. So M is not greater than N because 8 is not greater than 24. So we'll execute the else condition. So now we are going to execute N is equal to N minus M. So the value which will now be stored in N is 16, which is 24 minus 8 is 16, right? So we'll again go to this while loop. Again the value of M is not equal to N, therefore we'll come inside. The first statement will not be executed because M is 8 and N is 16, and 8 is not greater than 16, therefore we'll execute the else condition. In the else condition we are having N is equal to N minus M, therefore N is now going to store 8, which is 16 minus 8 is 8. Okay, now again we'll come to this while loop. Now the value of M and N are 8, so both the values are same, therefore will come out of this while loop and will print the value of N. So it will print the value N as 8. Now let us check out the options. So in the option number A, they are saying X divided by Y using repeated subtraction, right? So here we assumed the value of M as the value of X as 40 and the value of Y is 32. If we divide 40 by 32, then we'll get the value 1, because 40 and 32 both are integer numbers. So if we divide 40 by 32, then we will get 1. Okay, because we are going to ignore the fraction part. Now the second option is X mod Y using repeated subtraction. So what is 40 mod 32? If you do 40 mod 32, then you will get 8. Okay, so this second option may be correct. The third option is GCD of X and Y. So what is the GCD of 40 and 32? So GCD is greatest common divisor. That means the greatest number which is dividing both these numbers. And if you see here, we are getting 8, and 8 is the GCD of 40 and 32. Therefore option number C may also be correct. And in option number D, we are taking LCM of X and Y. So obviously the LCM of 40 and 32 will be greater than 40 and 32, but we are getting 8. So obviously this option will not be correct. So we are left with option number B and option number C. In option number B is also valid for this question, where we are taking the value of X is 42 and Y is 32. And option number C is also valid. So let us do one thing. Let us check out more options. Let us take some different value for X and Y. for the kind of values where all these things are different, right? So let us, this is the first iteration. Let us try a second iteration for the same question. So if we take the value of x and y and then m and n, so let us take the value of x as 15, the value of y as 5. Why? Because if we divide 15 by 5, we are going to get 3. If you divide 15 by 5, then we are going to get 3. If we take 15 mod 5, then we are going to get 0. If we take GCD of 15 and 5, then GCD is 5. And if we take LCM of 15 and 5, then the LCM is 15. That means for all these four cases, these values are different, right? So now let us try this program. So now we are going to copy the value of x to m. Therefore, m is now going to store 15. Then we are going to copy the value of y to n. Therefore, n is now going to store 5. Then while m is not equal to n, right? So 15 is not equal to 5, right? Therefore, we will come inside this while loop. In this while loop, the first condition is if m is greater than n, right? If m is greater than n, the value of m is 15 and the value of n is 5, and 15 is greater than 5, therefore this condition is true now. So we'll execute m is equal to m minus n. So m is now going to store 10. That is 15 minus 5 is 10, right? So we'll come again, come to this while loop, and we'll check the condition. So 10 is not equal to 15. Sorry, 10 is not equal to 5. Therefore, we'll come inside this while loop. We'll check if m is greater than n. The value of m, the value stored in m is 10. The value stored in n is 5. So 10 is greater than 5, obviously. Therefore, we'll execute the statement again. So it will make m, the value of m is 5, because 10 minus 5 is 5. Right, now both the values of m and n are equal, right? So this condition of the while loop will fail, so we will not execute this program anymore, while loop anymore. So we'll come to this printf statement, and we are going to print the value of n. The value of n is 5, right? So if you check the options, you can see that in option number C, the GCD of 15 and 5 are 5, right? Therefore, the option number C is correct for this question, okay?